We've got Vanessa Rader right here in her studio. Vanessa is going to give us her prompt for us for our special workshop session with her on August 30th. Vanessa is the author, illustrator of a new picture book coming out by Dial Books for Young Readers, Lucy and the String. Vanessa, what do you need to see from us?
So with our workshop, I'm going to be talking about the process that I went through to make my book, Lucy and the String, from the initial idea through all of the revisions and then the final product. But one of the aspects of the book that I really enjoyed exploring was the juxtaposition between the size of this small, little, ambitious and persistent girl versus the large, disgruntled, exasperated bear. Not only did their size difference make for dynamic visuals in the book, but just the idea that you've got a girl versus a beast, it helped me explore their relationship in this story. So that was a lot of fun. So with that being said, my illustration prompt for y'all is based on the word opposite.
Opposite, yes.
I encourage you to create an illustration depicting some sort of opposite, whether it be light versus dark, tall versus short, square or circle, you know, young and old, just the possibilities are endless. There's so many ideas.
That will really get some creative juices going, flowing.
It's fun. I've had this prompt before and it's fun to explore. One thing I want you to think about when you're creating your illustration is how the opposite aspect of your illustration will affect your scene or your characters, and how you can use that opposite to drive the narrative of your illustration. So I have a few examples here that might just help explain some of this. This is from A Sick Day.
Oh, wonderful book.
For Amos McGee. Yeah. And this spread right here, oops, let me get that out of the way, of the Amos McGee here playing chess with the elephant. And obviously their size is the big opposite in this illustration. And Aaron Steed, who illustrated this, not only used the size of the characters, but the size of the chairs. You see Amos McGee is in a larger chair here versus the elephant on this tiny stool. So that helps fuel the narrative, helps add humor to this picture. So that's a great example of one opposite. Here in Life by Cynthia Ryland, illustrated by Brendan Wenzel. This book is full of great opposites. I suggest, you know, if you have an opportunity to check it out, to look through it, because it has so many opposites. But this is just a great example of dark versus light. So not only do you get the color opposites here, you get, you see the ominous look of these brambles and thorns versus the calm, soothing feel of the sunlight, the warmth. And it really adds like attention to this illustration. So that's a good example of dark versus light. And then last, this is from a fellow girl illustrator, that's Shelly Ann Jackson, who's lives across the pond now in England. So she created this illustration. The opposite here is fast versus slow. So obviously we've got a slow sloth versus this very fast hummingbird. And these are actually characters from a book she's written that I think is out on submission. I'm not sure. But their whole characteristics of the fast and the slow drives the narrative of the book. So those are just a few examples of opposites. And just like Lelena had you turn your work in early, I encourage you to get your work uploaded by August 28th. So that will give me a couple of days to
August 28th. Okay.
That'll work. Give me a couple of days to look over the illustrations and pick, I figure, 10 to 15 pieces that I'll critique for y'all.
Great. Can you tell us a little more about the program you'll be doing for us on the 30th?
I'm going to talk about the creation of my book, Lucy and the String, the initial idea, how a book came from the single sketch that I did in my sketchbook, then the process I went through and getting an agent with the book, as well as working with the editor and art director at Penguin. And then finally, you know, the book coming out this Tuesday. So
your original picture book started off as a wordless book.
It was a wordless book and went to a rhyming book.
Okay.
And then, it was a wordless book, then it had words, then it was a rhyming book, then we took it out of rhyme. It went through a lot of different versions before we got to the final product. So it was a fun process, though.
Your characters are right behind you there, and they're going to be with us at the book signing party, the launch party at Book People on the 11th, Saturday the 11th in Austin, Texas. Can you tell us about your buddies back there?
This is Hank. And this is Lucy, the little girl, and Lucy.
They're opposites.
They are opposites. One's large and one's small. Lucy, in the book, she finds a string. She tugs on the string. She unravels this string into this huge piled mess. And then come to find out it's attached to a bear, a knitted bear. And she's unraveled half of his pants here, and so the rest of the book is her trying to figure out how to fix this problem that she's created. So she's in quite a mess here, but it's fun. She has a bunch of different scenarios where she comes up with solutions that she tries, and then they don't work, but they eventually find a solution that works, and they end up friends in the end.
They become friends in the end. Well, that's so much fun. Lucy and the String by author-illustrator Vanessa Rader, who is teaching our next Girl Illustrators Workshop all by herself on August 30th. And you have given us such an exciting, intriguing prompt. I think you're going to get so many submissions. It's going to be hard to choose, but you are going to select 10 from the group, and then hopefully the lessons you impart in talking about the 10 will be useful to all of us and beneficial. Thanks so much, Vanessa. We look forward to seeing you on the 30th, and maybe some of us will be seeing you at your book launch party on the 11th.
I hope so. It should be fun. These guys will be there. So yeah,
those guys will be there. You're bringing friends. Okay.
I'm bringing friends.
Thanks, Vanessa.
Thank you, Mark.
Bye-bye.